Absolutely. But you know, I think it's not about the wave clear. I think it's more about that the range, right? Because the Farsa, with the Farsa, technically what you can look for in the sieges is you're able to zone away these marksmen from hitting the minions, right? So it's not about the, just the pure wave clear. Because honestly, if I'm looking at both of the compositions, their wave clear, they're both equally good. One has more damage with the abilities, the other one goes for the old-fashioned way, like you mentioned, Leo. But it's all about that range. It's all about these dynamics from both of these matchups. The Farsa will definitely be a huge, huge disability for the Yi Sun Xian and the Natan. But then again, they also have this Yu Zhong. This Yu Zhong that is going to be just such a nuisance once again for the Farsa. It's all going to come down to how they execute these pushes, these sieges, these everything, and these team fights as well.
Yep. There's so much value eventually for this Farsa as the first pick four side of Blacklist International. It's a one-size-fits-all kind of hero. When it comes to the mid lane choices, Farsa has been one of the top priorities for teams because it is a hero that normally doesn't get banned out. And it's actually, you know, it fits almost all of the strategies because of that wave clear as well as this long-range vision that you get out, and there's also a stun. It's just really so much value for Blacklist International. To top it all off, OnicPH went for a double marksman setup, which, you know, Farsa loves to play in those kind of situations.
She just melts him. She just puts him down. But here we go. Wolf just explained exactly why Farsa is so important in the current metagame as she was years ago. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to game number two, Blacklist International versus OnicPH. It is indeed going to be a mid lane Pakito, and I feel like it's going to play the same role as a mid lane Cho without the CC, but more of a re-engage tool.
Let's see, again, Beloyski is going to be instantly in that top side towards Marky. I mean, this is technically
Look
what you
that.
Need. Yeah, all right. Marky's picking up that gold buff, and ooh, happy feet.
Yep. Yeah. You have to time it between the Renner Blast from Oheb, who is very, very, very good at doing that, stealing things from out of nowhere, from other people's noses. I'm wondering when Venus is going to do the same, when Venus is going to go help out.
Oh,
actually,
Haji.
Not just Haji here as well. It's a 3v1. Marky may have gone trapped, uses the flick already, and the stun, and speeding him up, and there's the kill. First Blood, brought to you by Razor, goes on over to Oheb.
Yep, very overzealous there, very overextended for Marky. He knew that Beloyski was no longer there. Technically, if Beloyski was still there, they could have gone for something. But again, yeah, Beloyski has other things on his plate. He needs to be able to secure these positions and open up the map. And there you go. Kyrie going into the enemy jungle.
Yep. Oh. Well, that's what Weiss also did.
Here comes a swing back. Level 4, Kyrie jumping in. Oheb looking low. Flicker already used up. Hatred dashing in, takes a few hits, and they disengage.
Yep. Might be pressuring the mid lane as well, as look at this Uranus just being a problem against this Yu Zhong. It's actually, when it comes to the Yu Zhong versus the Uranus, what the Uranus can do is just to cut the waves and actually not engage against the Yu Zhong, and might win that fight because of that.
Oh, Black Dragon form used up by Dilarski already. Haji retreating. Oh. Turtle secured here by the STB with the help of Kyrie. And that's going to be one down Wise. Traded out for Beloyski. Better airstrike by Haji. Dilarski taking a few hits, and they go ahead and retreat. Huge trade though. Huge swings on the map.
Yeah, that's really good for the side of Blacklist International. Sure, OnicPH, they were able to steal away the Turtle. That actually, now I'm confused. Because it's good for both of them, right? Kyrie getting the assist, getting that turtle, and also just scaling really well right now over than, you know, better than Wise at this point. If you can take a look at the items, he's already building towards, oh, wait a minute.
Warax. Venus taken down. You were saying War Axe.
Yeah, nope. All right. So he's already building towards that War Axe. And again, for Yi Sun Xian, this is one of the crucial items that you need to get early on to secure that. Those stacks are going to matter a lot, that movement speed. In the team fights, in the push, everything you do, it is going to rely on that right now. And on the Philippines, they need to just keep on scaling until those item power spikes hit.
Yep, and which really makes me think that OnicPH will try to play this slowly. As long as they're keeping their turrets, they're fine. Make sure that the mid lane turret will not be touched by Blacklist International. However, Blacklist International, they're just going to be waiting for their timing as well. Again, if there are two items available for Oheb, I'm assuming this will be the Demon Hunter Sword after the Blade of Despair. Combo that up with Haji's damage out from the Clock of Destiny and the Truncheon. The siege potential from Blacklist International, especially with two frontliners, it's going to be great. And OnicPH, they don't have the wave clear to stop that from happening.
And again, just in that moment earlier, this fight down here, it's a dance-off. It's two very chunky heroes going, ah, ah, ah. In mid, Haji alone, able to fight off three and clear the wave. That's how important the Farsa is in this game, and that's how great the wave clear is for Blacks International at this current stage of the game. 4 minutes in, Onyx Page want to set something up. They're blasting Haji from the bottom. Kairi, he still has his skateboard, his eponymous skateboard.
Yeah. I think he's waiting for his purple buff, and then the turtle will appear in 3 seconds. Edward most likely will just proxy the wave, just cut it out. Or maybe even join the fight. He's actually coming forward and might be joining the fight.
Watch out. They start with a Feather Airstrike. 4 men from Blacklist International set up for the second turtle. Mountain Shocker, they know exactly where everyone is. Dilarski coming in with the Black Dragon form. Catches the Queen. Circling Eagle Aster and Ba. And they catch so many bullets from Ohem. That's going to be one down. It's a trade. 2-for-1. Wise. Be Wise traded for Dilarski. And they're not done. They're not done. Marky tries to blast down Edward. And they disengage. So far, Onyx PH able to get away scot-free.
Yeah, and not just that, they get the turtle and now they're pushing in. Again, remember, Onyx PH, they have this composition which is actually kind of weaker here in the early stages. Managing to get the lead is going to be insane. Just going even alone or maybe even 1,000 gold behind, it's going to be fine for them. But guess what? They are in the lead right now, picking up the good fights, and look at how they're playing these team fights. Perfection. The winning condition really shining through here for Onyx.
And that's because of this Yu Zhong coming up from Dilarski. He did die in the clash, but he would manage to find Wise as well as Oh My Venus, and then eventually shut down Haji from popping off that feathered airstrike, and now they are beating him indeed.
They're finding him, and it's a 2v1 in mid and in top. They've switched their lanes after the second turtle, and Kairi coming in, threatening a kill onto Edward. Same story, bottom lane, and off-camera kill! Down goes Boiloiski, courtesy of Wise. Edward, he's okay, confident he's not gonna die. Take that tier 1 up top.
Yeah, absolutely. And now with the tier 1 up top, it is gonna set up for the next turtle, but Blacklist, they are looking for the trade. Marky getting sniped, and this is where he needs to recall. Nope, he cancels it. Wise and Venus.
He's sandwiched! It's too much to survive. Wise gets that, and they will convert directly into this tier 1.
Oh, let's see what happens here, though.
Detna's welcome! Get in my belly! Flicker already used up. Boiloiski getting it spotted here. Wise still stomping away. They retreat.
What a great pickoff coming up from Blacklist International. Because of the death of Boiloiski in the mid lane, was no one to actually supply the vision for Onyx PH to guard the side of Marky. And Blacklist International took full advantage of that.
Hatred so close to biting it. The huge range on this Feather Airstrike up top. Dilarski still trying to take down Edward. It's Boiloiski and Dilarski, the Ski Brothers. Here comes the rest of Blacklist International. Circling Eagle, Black Dragon form. They answer back. Oh, him with the passion, blasting him with that SMG. And look at this, Dilarski, he's low. He's right in the middle of all of them. Taken down by the sniper, point blank. Boiloiski blasting away. Kairi secures a third turtle. Was that worth it? A body for the turtle.
At this point for Onyx PH, that's okay. As long as it's not it's not Marky. Hatred.
Swing back, they answer. Edward puts a few stacks of the Ionic Edge. Marky to the rescue, cutting this team fight short.
Yeah, as I was saying, it's going to be a good trade because of the fact that it's not Marky who's dying in these fights. As long as Marky as well as Kairi are okay, are getting all of these farms, it's okay. But then again, you have to be careful if you're Dilarski. Maybe that's their last death. Eventually, Onyx PH will rely on the tankiness of both Boiloiski and Dilarski. Both of them not having the best kind of tank ability, but that is the best that Onyx PH can rely on in this game. Eventually, the lineup of Blacklist International can burst down these fighters, so you have to take note of not dying so that you get the farm for all those defensive items.
Wise already starting up with the Detna's Welcome, cancels it. In goes Marky. That's going to be a forward entropy, and down goes Wise. Enough firepower to go for the counter engage as Haji puts up a defensive feathered airstrike. They're not done though. The Queen says we can take this. The Queen says we can try to take this. And they're going to go ahead and defend bottom lane. Kairi going to get sandwiched. And he's going to use the passive. Crits onto the Filipino sniper. 2 free kills plus a turret down bottom. Onyx PH back on the map.
Like we said in the draft, it is this Yu Zhong that's just been crucial in these team fights. Look at the timing that Dilarski is able to use that Black Dragon form. He didn't do it initially. He waited up until Farsa was in position, then he pops it. That's where Haji, he just can't go for that feathered airstrike anymore. Now with the lightning truncheon built, he will do a significant more damage. But the thing is,
When are you going to use that ultimate? You have to have that perfect timing and the perfect positioning. That's not going to happen, man. Dolarski is just so on point with this Black Dragon form, and they're already using those pushes, those sieges, utilizing the Natan and that Yisun Shin.
Watch out for the map. It's a little bit of a split push for Onyx PH as they want to use Hatred on the mid lane role to get to show the minion wings up top.
Oh, it's a full-on engage as Dolarski has to use the Black Dragon form on a defensive way, and he's taken out by Wise on the retreat. No punish at all on the side of Onyx PH as Balanzi gets stunned and still survives, uses that flicker at the nick of time. But Lord here taken down to almost half health. Here comes Hatred, walks into a four-man, a three-man. He's dashing around Mountain Shocker. Kairi trying to keep his mid laner alive. Feathered Airstrike set in. Hatred from the north takes him down, traded for his own life. It's a messy team fight for Blacklist and Onyx. Neither want to give up this Lord.
Well played by Onyx Philippines. That should have been them losing every single time with Beloy, with Dolarski dead. But look at the way they're able to just save time, get some time on the board for Dolarski to spawn back. Sure, that was Hatred picked off, but it's a mid lane for the mid lane. Now with Dolarski here, it is going to be much, much better for the side of Onyx PH.
Oh man, this is crazy. As Dolarski really just relies on this Yu Zhang ultimate to really mess up with against Blacklist International. And then, of course, Hatred sniping Haji. Was it worth it? Because they still lost one hero for that. It's a one-for-one trade-off. I guess the answer is yes, because they, at least they stopped the Lord take from Blacklist International. But you have to be very careful about Onyx PH. Blacklist International is a team that really punishes those trades. When the trades look favorable for Onyx PH, it seems like Blacklist International just finding ways to even up the trade or even just one-up Onyx PH because of their small movements in the game. For example, really just poking this Dolarski Yu Zhong to the point where he's forced to use the ultimate.
Now let's take a look at the items here with Kairi building up already the BOD, all right? This is where he is going to be so powerful. Maybe next item is going to be the Malefic Roar or the DHS. It's going to be either one, all right? It's preference for the side of Onyx PH.
Starting it up with the Feathered Airstrike.
Not good.
Not good. I mean, it was used for vision. They do have that. They need that to be able to open up the map. And Haji spotted by Marquee. That's a lot of damage, but Beloyski will not fully commit. Maybe once bitten, twice shy, Beloyski.
Yeah. There was a time where Marky is called the bad boy by Mr. Manjin himself, and that is the reason why.
Here we go. Circling Eagle plus the Black Dragon form Lord at about a fifth of its health. Wise Denton as well. Kairi gets blasted with the Feathered Airstrike. That's the Lord secured by the Queen. Wow. There's a knockup. Three down for the side of Onyx PH. Blacklist International punishes the micro mistakes as Beloyski bites it. Edward takes his head. It's only one left. It's just Hatred.
A huge mistake for Onyx PH. Not just the timing of that fight, but look at the members. Hatred was nowhere near that Lord, and they still forced it out. That was them getting overzealous, greedy, and Blacklist will completely just punish them.
Oh my god, it's not an enhanced Lord, but there's no wave clear. Again, the problem for Onyx PH,
they can end.
They don't have the wave clear. They have Marquee this time.
Hatred catches way too much via the Feather Airstrike and the Nibiru's Passion. Mountain Shocker to help clear the waves and push back Blacklist. It's not going to end. Not here.
That is going to be so, so bad for Onyx PH, man. They've lost that inhibitor turret in the mid lane. Remember, the side lanes are bad, but that mid lane is going to be bad, even worse here, as they're just, they might just go in for the push.
They're not letting go. Look at where Edward is. He's putting so many stats on the people. Feathered Airstrike one more time. Beloyski caught out of home. There's a Tota's welcome. Get in my belly and down under the ground. Wise takes him, as well as the inhibitor turret down bottom. Top lane going to be next up on the docket for Blacklist International. They are calculated. They are taking down these turrets surgically. Precise. There's another Feathered Airstrike. Does this thing not have a cooldown? Black Dragon Form Force out of Dolarski. They're bursting him down. He's going to survive. There's a Mount Shocker landing on all five members of Blacklist International, but they're not done. Hatred weaving in and out, stinging like a bee. There's a knockup. Down goes Edward. Huge punish on it. But the Filipino sniper takes one from the back. Kairi goes down, Dolarski as well. Three defenders left, but it's not done, not quite yet. As Hatred gets taken down again, dual wielding, taking him down with Nibiru, circling Eagle by Beloyski. He's caught out, second time in the past 2 minutes. He's still alive. Trying to distract him, but it's not gonna happen. Marky gets taken down by Haji. Max range. Ladies and gentlemen, that's a wipeout. Game number two going over to Blacklist International.
The Filipino sniper, what was that?
head. Look at him. He's hyped. Don't give this man a hero with guns. Ban out the Clint. Ban out the Beatrix. At this point, ban out the Layla from this man. And.